This is my brief profile. I obtained BTech and PhD from Sri Venkateswara University, Tirupati of Andhra Pradesh, and I obtained MTech from a National Institute of Engineering, Mysore. My specialization, water resource engineering. I have more than 20 years of teaching and industry experience. I taught both undergraduate and postgraduate students. I have published n number of technical papers in repeated national and international journals, and also I took part in several national international conferences and workshops. The next, design. Design and drawing of irrigation structures. The next design is canal regulator. It is a structure at the head of the canal taking of water from a reservoir river, from where we can get water to the networking of canal, either from the reservoir, backside of the dam, or a river, perennial river. It consists of number of spans separated by piers and operated by gates. Regulators are normally aligned at 90 degrees to the weir. This is a canal regulator. To withdraw water from river or from the reservoir, between two piers, shutter operating system. If you observe here, this is the river. From the river, this is a barrage or weir and will be diverted into here, and canal head regulator. Here we construct the canal head regulator to the main canal, and main canal to branch canal to distributary, distributed to the minor, minor to the water channel to the fill. This is the networking of the canal. Main canal to branch canal to distributary, distributed to the major distributor to the minor distributary, minor distributor to the filled channel, or it is also called water course to the field. This is the networking of canal. Water will be diverted by constructing across barrage or weir through this regulator. Here we will regulate the flow entering into the networking of the canals. This is the model. Usually this is the path, road path, addition to that operating platform. Usually all the structures in constructing in a rural area, it will be linked with the road, your rural road and working platform. These are the piers in between that the water will be flowing. Design a regulator cum road bridge with the following data. Hydraulic particulars of a canal upstream side of the canal, hydraulic particulars. Full supply discharge, 20 meter cube per second. Bed width, 15 meters. Bed level, 20.00. Full supply depth, 2 meters. Full supply level, 22.00. Top level of bank, 23.00. The right bank is 5 meters wide and left bank is 2 meters wide. Hydraulic particulars of canal downstream. Full supply discharge, 16 meter cube per second. Bed width, 15 meters. Bed level, 20.00. Full supply depth, 1.75 meters. Full supply level, 21.75. Top level of bank, 22.75. Good foundation soil is available at 19. The general ground level at the site, 22. Top width of the banks are the same as those on the upstream side. The regulator carries a roadway that is a single lane designed as per the IRC code class A. Provide a clear freeboard of 1 meter above full supply level for the road bridge. That means the water flowing in this and the bridge, there is a clear cover of 1 meter freeboard. Using all this data, you draw the to a suitable scale of planet foundation and of planet top of sectional elevation cross section. As usual, the value is given in the bracket is for your homework. The various components to be designed. Vent way of the regulator, this is the vent way. From here to here, the vent way of the regulator. Roadway, this is the roadway. Working platform, this is the working platform. Pier dimensions, what is the dimension of this pier? Length is how much? The thickness is how much? Stability of the pier. First you assume the dimensions and check whether it is stable for the forces or not. Bank connections. These are all the bank connections on the both the sides. Solid aprons for regulator. This is the solid apron. Rough stone aprons and rivetments. These are the rough stone aprons and rivetments. Sides, revetment and this is the apron. Energy dissipation arrangements, these are the energy. Blocks will be arranged, staggered friction blocks to dissipate the energy. These are the various components to be designed. First component we will see, vent way of the regulator. The width of the canal at the work site is reduced in order to achieve economy, and at the same time we should not reduce too much, will result formation of a lot of eddies, thus increase the maintenance cost. We can reduce to the width of the canal, but if we reduce too much, it will result the formation of lot of eddies. It increases the maintenance cost. So narrowing of the canal waterway should not be less than 50% of the upstream side canal. Narrowing the canal of waterway should not be more than 50% of the canal. So you can reduce up to 50% only. The width of the vent way equal to 0.5 into upstream side bed width. So 7.5 meter. We can provide the same one single length of 7.5, and you can provide the one shutter. But instead of having one span of 7.5 meters, it is better to adopt smaller spans, both on economy of the top roadway and also for the convenience with which similar shutter can easily be operated. So adopt three spans of each 2.5 meters. So we can provide 7.5 meters in a single shutter, but in order to easy operation, you divide it into three portions and put three shutters. So the total length between these two, I mean these openings, 2.5, 2.5, 2.5, adopt three spans of 2.5 each. Assuming the vent way of the regulator is a rectangular orifice, submerged orifice, then the discharge through the orifice is through the regulator, Q equal to CD into A into root 2 J. Q is given 16 meter cubed per second. Assuming CD 0.75, H is the head causing flow. Head causing flow is upstream side full supply level and downstream side full supply level. That is 22 minus 21.75, 0.25 meter. Substitute all this, you can get the area equal to 9.64 square meter. The depth of vent way equal to area by width. Area is 9.64, width is 7.5, 1.25, you round it up to near to 1.3. So the depth is 1.3. The sill of the regulator has to be raised by 1.75 meter minus 1.3, 0.45 meter above downstream side bed level. Why you should raise up to 0.45 meters? Actually we need 1.3, but here it is a 1.75. In order to compromise that way, I raised it here and we provided a rising portion of 0.45 meter. Then the sill of the regulator equal to downstream side bed level plus 0.45 meter, that is 20.45. The dimensions of each vent is 2.5 meters width and the depth is 1.3 meters. Roadway. Since it is required to design the roadbeds for a single lane class A loading according to IRC, the clear width of the road is 3.65 meters. As per IRC, the minimum roadway is 3.65 meter. Width of each curb at the edge of the road, we are providing a curb, safety divisor. Curb 23 centimeters. Two such number, left side and right side. The grass width of the road, 0.23 plus 3.65 plus 0.23. Total 4.11 meter. From here to here, 4.11 meter. The road will be a throw RCC slab directly resting over the piers and abutment. The bottom level of the road slab is kept at 1 meter above upstream side full supply level. It is mentioned the freeboard should be maintained 1 meter. Therefore, the bottom level of the road slab equal to upstream side full supply level plus 123. Let the thickness of road slab, slab thickness plus bearing coat, let us assume 20 centimeters and bearing coat is 7.5 centimeters. Together 27.5 centimeters, that is 0.275 meters. Top level of the road slab the bottom level of the roads have plus thickness. Bottom level is 23, the thickness 0.275. So approximately you take 23.28. In order to drain off the rainwater, a camber is provided on the roadway in the veering court of its dimensions 7.5 cm at the middle center and 5 cm at the edge. A camber will be provided in the veering court. Here more depth 7.5, here 5. So the camber to drain off the drainage water. Working platform. This is the road and this is the working platform. A working platform is provided to operate the shutters. Why we need the working platform to operate the shutters? The normal width of the working platform may be taken as 1.5 meter. Usually it is 1.5 meters. The top level of the working platform is so fixed such that the shutter should move only in the grooves without free oscillation. This level should be such that the shutters we are keeping, that should be moved in the grooves only, not in the oscillation in the air. That way we should be designed this. Next one, pier. Length of the pier, this is the pier. Height of the pier, length of the pier, width of the pier, that gives the dimensions. This is the pier. And shutters here, we are providing the shutters here. Here, abutments, wing walls, downstream side wing wall, downstream side return, upstream side wing walls, upstream side returns. Pier, the length of the pier. It should be adequate to support road slab and working platform. Both are resting on the pier. So, it should be adequate to support road width and working platform. The length of the pier, with these conditions, what is the length of the pier? Road width plus width of the platform. Road width is how much? 4.11. Width of the platform? 1.5. You add it both, we can get 5.61 meters. Of course, you are omitting the cutwaters. What is this cutwater? This portion we call it as a cutwater. Without considering that, from here to here, this is the 5.61 meters. Height of the pier. Here, two heights of the pier. One is one height below the road slab, another height below the working platform. The pier has to support road slab and working platform. Both are at a different elevation. This is at one elevation, this is at another elevation. Therefore, pier will have two different heights. They are the portion supporting the road slab, the portion supporting the road slab, the portion supporting the working platform. First, we will see the portion supporting the road slab. Hard soil for foundation are available at 19. Taking 20 cm deep into hard soil, no doubt we can put it a foundation concrete here, but it is better to remove hard soil up to 20 cm. From that, you lay the concrete. Then, bottom of foundation concrete equal to 19 minus 0.2, 18.88. Assuming 60 cm thickness concrete, top of foundation concrete equal to bottom of the foundation concrete plus thickness, that is 19.40. Bottom level of the pier equal to top of the foundation concrete, that is 19.40. Top level of the pier equal to bottom level of the road slab 23. The height of the pier supporting the road slab equal to 23.00 minus 19.40, that equal to 3.64. So the height of the pier supporting the road slab is 3.6 meters. The next one, the portion supporting the working platform. In order to determine this height, it is first of all necessary to determine the level of the working platform and it is function of height of the shutter. So, if you want to find out the height, first of all we should find out what are the shutter height. Based upon that only, we should find out what is the height of the pier under the working platform. First, we will go for the design of shutter. The shutter top is to be at least 30 cm above the upstream side full supply level. Therefore, top level of the shutter equal to upstream side full supply level plus 0.3, that equal to 22.00 plus 0.3. So, the top level of the shutter is 22.30. The bottom level of the shutter is fixed based on the depth of groove provided at the canal bed level in order to ensure no leakage of water onto the downstream side. Suppose if you see here, if you provide the shutter here, there is a possibility of leakage of water from upstream to downstream side. In order to prevent it, provide a groove over that the shutter should be placed so that no question of seepage of water from upstream to downstream side. When we shall close the shutter, we can minimize the wastage of water. The bottom level of the shutter is fixed based on the depth of groove provided at the canal bed level in order to ensure no leakage of water onto the downstream side. Assuming a groove of 8 cm, this 8 cm, then bottom level of the shutter equal to bed level is 20, minus depth of the groove, 19.92. Therefore, the height of the shutter equal to 22.30 minus 19.92, that is 2.38 meters. Therefore, the height of the shutter equal to 2.38 from here to here, the height of the shutter. This height of the shutter causes inconvenience during operation and also it is uneconomical providing a one single shutter. Hence, a two-tier shutter is provided and they will be arranged in two grooves and operating side by side. Instead of one shutter from here to here, we are providing a two shutters side by side and we are operating two shutters. Assuming a overlap of 25 cm, if you are operating two shutters, you should be stop here and when it will come, there should be always 25 cm overlap. Providing a bottom shutter 1.38 meters height and top shutter 1.25 meters height, then the total height equal to 1.38 plus 1.25, 2.63. Therefore, bottom level of the working platform equal to upstream side full supply level plus height of the shutter 22 plus 1.38, 23.38. Assuming a clearance of 30 cm above the shutter, assume 30 cm of clearance. Then bottom level of the working platform equal to this 23.38 plus 0.3, 23.68. You rounded it up to nearer value 24. Let us say the bottom level of the working platform is fixed at 24. Top of the pier equal to bottom of the working platform. This is the bottom of the working platform. Bottom of the pier, top of the foundation concrete, 19.4. Therefore, height of the pier under working platform equal to top of the pier 24 minus bottom of the pier 19.4, that equal to 4.6 meter. Therefore, the height of the pier below the working platform is 4.6 meters. Stability of the pier. Various loads acting on the pier, assuming 1 meter pier thickness. Let us assume the thickness of the pier is 1 meter. Weight of the road slab. Let us consider it as a P1. P1 is the weight of the slab plus weight of the caps plus weight of the bearing coat. Weight of the slab, how much? Length 4.11 and thickness 0.2 and this length 2.5 plus 1 half of the pier into, this is the volume, into 2400 plus weight of the caps plus weight of the bearing coat, then we can get this is the P1. P1 is acting at a lever arm of 4.11 by 2. Now if we take the moments about this, it will be acting half of this distance, 4.11 by 2, from the toe of the pier. From the toe of the pier, the point of application of this weight of the road slab is 2.05 meters. Weight of the pier under the road portion, P2, if you take this weight of the pier and road portion, P2 is length, thickness and height, volume, into specific weight of masonry. Length is 4.11 and height is, thickness is 1 meter, height equal to 23 minus 19.4 into unit weight of masonry, this masonry, and you can get this value. P2 is acting at a lever arm of, from the lever arm here to here, 4.11 by 2, 2.0 meter. Similarly, weight of the pier under the working platform. This is the weight of the pier under the road slab P2 and this is the weight of the pier under working platform, it is P3. P3 is 1.5 thickness, width, thickness 1 meter and 24 minus 9.4 into 2100, we can get this is the weight. And it is acting in a lever arm from here to here. First 4.11 plus this is a rectangular. So 1.5 by 2. 1.5 by 2 plus 4.11, that 4.6 meters. Water thrust on the pier, that we call it as horizontal thrust. Let us consider it as a PH. Horizontal thrust exerted by water onto the shutter, finally transmitted to the pier. H equal to upstream side full supply depth, 2 meters. Horizontal length, 2.5 plus 1. How we got this 2.5 plus 1? 2.5 is the distance between pier to pier or pier to abutment. One is half of this side, half of the pier 0.5. Another side half of the pier 0.5, so total together 1. That is why 2.5 plus 1, 3.5 meter. pH equal to 3.5 into half gamma H square. Gamma is the unit weight of water, and we substitute all this. Where it is acting? It is acting at a height of 1/3 of the height. That is 1/3 of height, 0.6 meters above the toe. Now, taking moments of all forces above the toe. Name of the force? P1, P2, P3, P4, description, weight of the road slab, weight of the pier, actually it is the weight of the pier under the road portion, weight of the pier under working platform, horizontal thrust, forces, horizontal force, vertical forces, these are the values. Lever arm, moment, force into lever arm, this is the moment. Sigma m, sum of all these things, sigma m, sum of v, sum of all the three, sigma v, sum of this, sigma h. Lever arm of resultant equal to sigma m by sigma v, sigma m by sigma v, 2.69 meters. Eccentricity, e equal to b by 2 minus x bar, b by 2 is 4.11 plus 1.5 by 2 minus 2.5. Allowable eccentricity, 5.61 by 6.94 meters. Hence, the resultant falls within the middle third and no tension develops in masonry pier. No doubt, it is safe against the tension, but it should be checked whether it may be crushed at the bottom because of its self-weight. In order to know whether the structure is crushed at the bottom of the pier, we should know what is the maximum compressive stresses are available, whether it is within the permissible limit. If it is at the permissible limit, then it can be safe. Maximum compressive stresses are sigma v by b into 1. 1 plus 6e by b. Sigma v, already we know, b we calculated into 1. 1 plus 6e by b we can get. And we can get, this is the maximum compressive. But it is the permissible limit is 30. Less than this, then the structure is safe. Hence, the design is safe and the thickness of the pier as proposed can be adapted. Next, we will see the bank connections. These are all the bank connections. Abutment, downstream side wing wall, downstream side return, upstream side wing wall, upstream side return. First, we will see the abutment. Abutment is the portion AB. The top level of the abutment equal to bottom level of the road. That is 23. Bottom level of the abutment equal to top of foundation concrete. That is 19.4. Therefore, height of the abutment, top level minus bottom level of the abutment, 3.6 meters. Bottom width is, as usual, 40% of the height, 0.4 into 3.6, 1.44 meters. Better you provide 2 meters. Assuming top width is 1 meter, out of which 50 centimeters will be bearing for RCC road slab. Assume total 1 meter, but 50%, that is 0.5 meters to bear the RCC road slab. The front face is to be vertical. Here you should not provide a batter. If you provide the batter, we cannot operate the shutter. Whenever we are operating the shutter, this portion should be vertical. The front face is to be vertical to facilitate the working of the regulator shutters in the vertical grooves. Wing walls. The wing wall on the upstream side and downstream side are sloping up to a respective tank band levels of the bank. Whether it is the upstream, downstream side, or upstream side, both are sloping wing walls only, no straight wing wall. Upstream side wing wall, portion B to C, we call it as a upstream side wing wall. Sloping from 23.8 to 23, that is the tank bond level. Section at B, top level 23.28. Bottom level, that is the top of foundation concrete, 19.40. Height, top level minus bottom level, 3.88 meters. bottom width 40% of that, 0.4 into 3.88, 1.5, let us consider 1.6 meters. Assuming top width is 0.5 meters and front battery is 1 unit. In the wing walls, returns, upstream side wing walls, upstream side return, downstream side wing walls, downstream side returns, we can provide a battery of 1 unit, except for the abutment, because here we are using the, we are operating the shutter. Except this abutment, the remaining things, you provide a front battery 1 unit. Section at C, if you see at section, because it is a sloping, top level is 23, that is the tank 1 level. Bottom level, top of the foundation, 19.4. Height, top minus bottom, 3.6. Bottom width, 0.4 times of the height, 1.4. Let us consider 1.4. Top width, as usual, 0.5 meters. Front battery, 1:8. Upstream side, return, CD. Actually, it is CD is a horizontal one. Whatever the section you are providing at C, the same section may be provided at D also. Downstream side wing wall. A to E, we call it as a downstream side wing wall. It is sloping from 23.28 to 22.75. That is the tank one level of the downstream side 22. Section at A is same as that of section at B. Section at E, here the section at E. Top level equal to 22.7. Bottom level, top of foundation concrete, 19.4. Height equal to top level minus bottom level, 3.35 meters. Bottom width, 40% of the height, 0.4 into 3.25, 1.3. Let us take 1.4 meters. Top width, as usual, 0.5 meters. And front battery is 1:8. So, because it is sloping, here the section at A, at section E will be different. But the return, if you consider the downstream side return EF, from E to F, it is a horizontal one. So, base width may not be changed. Hence, provide whatever the section you are providing at E, same section to be continued up to E. Next, seventh step, solid aprons for the regulator. Solid apron, this is the solid apron. Solid aprons are required to prevent the seepage when the regulator is closed with canal at full supply level on the upstream side and no water on the downstream side. This solid apron will be laid with its top level at the canal bed level. So, this will be for worst case, the design, let us assume, suppose the shutters are closed, the water is up to full supply level, there is no water on the downstream side. This is the worst case to design the solid apron. The design of the solid apron means, what is the length of the solid apron? What is the thickness of this apron? First, we will see what is the length of the apron from here to here, how much is the length. Length of the apron equal to creep length. That means the energy water, if you process from here to here, if you dissipated by reaching this, then this length is sufficient. So, this length of the apron equal to the creep length. Assuming bed material as the sandy soil and taking a hedral gradient of 1 in 5. Generally, for sandy soils, hedral gradient is 1 in 5. For clay soils, 1 in 4 or 1 in 5. Total energy to be dissipated. How much of the energy it is there? For worst condition, we close the shutters. The water is up to full supply level. On the downstream side, there is no water. Then, the total energy to be dissipated, full supply level minus downstream side bed level. Upstream side full supply depth minus downstream side bed level. That is 22.00 minus 22 meters. This is the energy to be dissipated, 2 meters energy. This, therefore, total length of the apron required equal to, if 1 in 10 is the ideal gradient, if 2 meters of energy to be dissipated, you should travel 10 into 2, 20 meters. Then, the creep length should be 20 meters. This 20 meters apron flow is provided as 6 meters on the upstream side. If you see here, this upstream side 6 meters, 5.6 meters under the regulator, 4.85 plus 1.5 by 2. Under the regulator and the balancing on downstream side. Assuming that the shutters are located in the center of the operating platform, the maximum uplift is at just downstream of the shutter, that is at point B. From point A to B, there is no question of uplift. You suppose if the water is entering from A to B, because of this self weight, no pressure will be, because of water will be withstanding here, no uplift pressure will be existing. So provide a nominal thickness of 30 cm from here to here, 30 cm. But in the figure we shown, it is the same thickness, but from A to here, you provide 30 cm thickness. Thickness at point B, this is the critical point. How much is the distance traveled, creep length from A to B? 6.75 meters. Head loss in creep at B, 6.7 by 10, because hydral gradient is 1 in 10. Therefore, it is 0.675 meters. Residual head, total head minus head loss. So, this is the head, residual head to be dissipated. Then the thickness at B equal to, as usual, residual head divided by G minus 1. Specific gravity of the material 2.25, substitute it, you can get 1.06 meters, say approximately 1 meter. After point B, the uplift decreases. So, we may reduce the thickness of upperon. Here, the maximum thickness will be occurring 1 and go on. The uplift pressure is reduced. So, we can reduce the cross-section also. Therefore, from point B to the end of the upperon, 1 meter thickness can be gradually reduced to 60 cm thick at the end of the upperon. Rough stone upperons and revetments. In continuation of solid upperon, both upstream and downstream side, provide 3 to 5 meters of length of rough stone upperon of thickness 45 centimeters, and also provide same length of the rough stone revetments on the canal slopes to a thickness of 45 centimeters. So, this is the rough stone pitching or revetment, side slopes revetment. Energy dissipation arrangements. In order to dissipate the energy of water coming out of the regulator, 2 or 3 rows of friction blocks may be provided in a staggered manner on the solid upperon. Suppose if it is coming from this, this is one friction block, another friction block. That means staggered one, when the flow coming out and it will be going out and it will be dissipated. So, this opening opposite to this opening, provide another block. This way, we provide staggered blocks to dissipate the residual energy. This is the drying of the canal regulator. As usual, if we consider this portion, it is a upland at top. This is upland at foundation. This is the piers, because we are considering the 3 vents. One vent is between abutment and wing, abutment and pier. In between the piers, another vent. In between the pier and abutment, another. So, 3 vents. And these are the shutters. These 2 are the piers. So, as usual, first you draw this center line. We know the distance between 2 piers is 2.5. Take this as the center point line and it is the top line. This is dotted. Because we are drawing here the dotted line, because it is under buried under the structure. Because it is a plan, here we cannot see from the top. That is why we are drawing the dotted line. From 2.5 meters from center line to half of that, and similarly half of that. Then you draw the this center line. And from this, we know 4.11 is the roadway. From the center of the roadway, 4.1 half of that, you show that. And you show this is the working platform. This is the upstream side, working platform, 1 point from here to here, 1.5 meter. This cut water, same, the thickness 1 meter, provide the diameter also 1 meter here, 1 meter, half of that 0.5 meter, with that you draw the cut water. Similarly, you draw this. This portion, excess portion is the bed width, below the foundation concrete, and you finish up. From here also, from here to here, 2.5 meters. From here to here, 2.5 meters. This is the upstream side wing wall, upstream side return, abutment, downstream side wing wall, downstream side return. These are the battle line. The first line is the battle line, 1 in 8. Using that 1 in 8, you suppose if you consider here, if you take this level and this level, by 8 we can get this better width. You draw that better width and similarly you draw the return. Here also the return, this is the better line. Here we have shown the cut portion because we are unable to draw the entire length of the apron. Hence we provided this, shown this cut portion. Here also we shown this cut portion and you draw the downstream side apron and downstream side revetment. Upstream side apron, upstream side the revetment. Because it is a channel section, it has tank bund level and it is sloping and it is a berm, and once again it is berm is a horizontal portion. If you observe, it is a berm sloping, tank bund level, once again it is sloping, this side also sloping and reaching the ground level. This is the cross section of the channel. This way you draw it. Similarly, here it is shown this line, that same is tells that it is sloping in this direction. But here there is no sloping, that is why you shown this symbol. That means it is a horizontal portion. Similarly, you draw this side also. Once you completed, you go there. Whatever the dot thick lines, that it will come here as a dotted line. Section at CC. Suppose if you take the section at CC, so total how much you see this? The same width thickness you provide from here to here. We know the top width 0.5 meter. Front batter, this is 30 centimeters offset of the concrete on both the sides. And this from the batter, this level minus this level by 8, we can get this. That is the from here to here. And we know the width, you put it and you extend it. We know this is the reduced length between the abutment, we know that length, and we know here the 6 meter. We know this length of the rivet apron. Based on that, you provide the transition plate. Once you completed, you extend this. This is the elevation after construction. If you see that, that is why it shown lines. That means it is sloping. It is after construction how it looks. This is after cutting in between, then how it looks. This is the way it looks. Similarly, you extend this into this way. Section through the regulator vent. This is the roadway pier, below the roadway pier, platform, below that platform pier, and this is also pier, extension of the pier. Here we have shown lines so that it tells that it is a pier. Similarly, this is the wing wall and this is the wing wall, straight line, and you finish off this. All you can finish off it. For reference, you may verify this test book. For desktop applications, you may contact her. Once again, I briefly explain about the canal regulator. It is a structure at the head of canal taking of water from a reservoir or river. It consists of number of spans separated by piers and operated by gates. This is the example of canal regulators. Usually, at head of the canal, we call it as a canal head regulator. It will be under the networking of the canals. Design of a rectangle cum road bridge. Usually, it will be clubbed with the road bridges because it is usually in the villages. Hydraulic properties of the canal upstream. Full supply discharge, bed width, bed level, full supply depth, full supply level, top level of bank. The right bank 5 meters wide, at left bank is 2 meters wide. Hydraulic properties of the canal downstream side. Full supply discharge, bed width, bed level, full supply depth, full supply level, top level of the bank. Good foundation is available at so-and-so. The general ground level, top width of the banks. Draw to a suitable scale, plan of sectional elevation, cross section. The various components to be designed. Vent way of the regulator, this is the vent way. Roadway, working platform, this is the working platform. Pier dimensions, this is the pier. Stability of the pier. Bank connections, these are the bank connections. Solid aprons for regulator, this is the solid apron. That means thickness and length of the apron. Rough stone aprons and revetment. Rough stone apron and revetment. Energy dissipation arrangements. These are the energy dissipation arrangements. Under the first step in the design, vent way of the regulator. We can reduce the width of the canal, but it cannot be too much. We cannot reduce. We can reduce up to 50% of the upstream side bed width. 50% of upstream side bed width is 7.5 meter. Instead of having a span of 7.5 meters single, it is better to provide each 2.5 so that we can easily operate the shutters. Assuming the vent way of the regulator in a rectangular orifice, use this equation, substituting that, find out the area. Once you know the area, we can find out what is the depth 1.5. But as per that, it is 1.75. To reduce that, increase a 0.45 units of pump will provide, and we can make it 1.3 meters. So the width is 2.5 meters and depth of the vent equal to 1.3 meters. Then the sill of the regulator keep it. Now the dimensions of each vent is 2.5 meters by 1.3 meters. Next, roadway. Roadway, it is for a single lane class A roading. The minimum width is 3.65 meters and you provide the kerb. Assume the thickness of the slab 20 cm and veering coat, and find out whether the thickness is sufficient or not, and finally keep the dimensions of the roadway. Working platform. The working platform, usually it is a width of 1.5 meters. The working platform, the top of the working platform is so fixed such that shutter should move only in the grooves without free oscillation. If it is a small, it can, the shutters may be oscillated. Hence, you should be fit the shutters. Pier, length of the pier, how much? Length of the pier, road portion and working platform portion. Road portion 4.1, working platform 1.5, 5.61. Height of the pier, there are two heights of the pier. One is below the road slab and below the shutter. Below the road slab, the portion, top level minus bottom level, you can get 3.6 meters. But below the working platform, it depends upon height of the shutter. The height of the shutters can be designed in this way. Top level of the shutter equal to upstream side full supply level plus 30 centimeters 22. Based on that, you can calculate this is the height of the shutter. No doubt, we can provide a single shutter of 2.38. However, provide two shutters side by side, each 1.38 plus 1.25. That way you provide the shutter. So from that, once you fix up the shutters, we can fix up the height of the pier under working platform 24 minus 19.4, 4.6 meter. That means height of the pier under the working platform is 4.6 meter. Stability of the pier. The various forces acting on the pier are weight of the road slab, weight of the pier under the road portion, weight of the pier under working platform, weight of the water thrust, and so take a tabular column and find out, check whether the eccentricity is within the limit or. If you observe here, it is only 0.94 within the permissible limit. Hence, it is safe against the tension. However, we check for the maximum compressive stresses using this equation. Here also, it is less than the permissible compressive stress. Hence, it is safe. Hence, the same dimensions may be adapted. Next, we are coming to the bank connection. As usual, AB is the abutment, AE is the downstream side wing wall, EF is the downstream side return, BC is the upstream side wing wall, CD is the upstream side return. AB, the abutment. Abutment, except the abutment, remaining all bank connections, you take 1 in 8, but don't take 1 in 8 here, it should be vertical, because we are using the shutters. So as usual, top level minus bottom level is the height, height into 40% is the width. Similarly, all this bank connections, wing walls, upstream side wing wall, BC, at section at B, at section at C, at section at D, CD is the return. Downstream side wing wall, AE, sloping from 23.28 to 22, that is the tank bond level. Section at A equal to section at B, section at E, our top level minus bottom level, height, height into 0.4, bottom width, assume top width 0.5 meters, front batter 1 in 8, section at F equal to section at E. Solid apron. Solid apron will be serve two purposes. One is solid apron design means length and thickness. Length to take care of the piping, assuming hydraulic gradient of 1 in 10, find out how much of the creep length into 2. Energy dissipated is 2. 2 into 10 ideal gradient will get 20 meters is the creep length. Creep length equal to length of the apron. Worst case for design of the thickness is when the shutter is closed and there is no water on the downstream side and water level on the upstream side is at full supply level. The maximum head is dissipated full supply level on the upstream side minus downstream side bed level 22 minus 20 2 meter. To dissipate the 2 energy, this is the worst case for thickness at point B. No doubt there is no uplift because the water is standing on that. So here you check the, for that reason you provide a 30 centimeter thickness here and you check the thickness at B. How can we check it? How much of the distance A to B it is traveled? How much distance it is traveled? That is the creep length from A to B. 6.75 meters. At last in creep at B equal to 6.75 by 10. 1 in 10 is the ideal gradient. So the energy lost when the water particles travels from A to B is 0.65. What is the total energy to be dissipated to? 2 minus 0.675. Still there is a residual head to dissipate 1.325. For that, the thickness to be provided here, residual head divided by g minus 1. Residual head is 1.325. Specific gravity is 2.25 minus 1, 1.6, say 1 meter. After point B, the uplift is decreases, so we may reduce the thicknesses of apron. Therefore, from point B to the end of the apron, 1 meter thickness can be gradually reduced to 60 centimeter thickness at the end of the apron. Here we have shown different same thickness, but from here to here 30 centimeter, here 1 meter, and it will be gradually reduced. Rough stone aprons. In continuous of solid aprons, both upstreams, even though the energy is dissipated, still there is a possibility of energy. That is the reason we provide a rough stone rivetment and rough stone pitching apron. This way you provide it. Similarly, energy dissipation arrangement, you provide a friction block in a staggered manner. That means, if you provided here, opposite to that gap, you provide a another block so that water can be traveled here and will take it out and it will be heated and it will be slided out so that the velocity can be reduced. Velocity can be reduced means we can reduce the energy. We can dissipate the energy.